केंद्रीय उर्वरक एवं रसायन मंत्री डीवी सदानंद गौड़ा ने कहा है कि गोरखपुर का खाद कारखाना 30 जून से चालू हो जाएगा। उन्होंने कहा कि एक साल का समय वैश्विक महामारी कोरोना से प्रभावित रहने के बावजूद कार्य समयबद्ध तरीके से आगे बढ़ सका तो इसका श्रेय राज्य की योगी सरकार को है। श्री गौड़ा गुरुवार को गोरखपुर में मुख्यमंत्री योगी आदित्यनाथ के साथ हिंदुस्तान उर्वरक एवं रसायन लिमिटेड HURL के खाद कारखाना का निरीक्षण करने के बाद पत्रकारों से बात कर रहे थे। उन्होंने कहा कि 98% कार्य पूर्ण हो चुका है। केंद्रीय मंत्री ने कहा कि 2 दशक पहले पुराने खाद कारखाने के बंद होने के बाद उसकी जगह आधुनिक नया कारखाना लगाने की मांग बतौर सांसद योगी आदित्यनाथ लगातार करते रहे। संसद के हर सत्र वह इसकी आवाज उठाते रहे। आज उनका सपना पूरा होने जा रहा है। उन्होंने सीएम योगी की इस बात की सराहना की कि मुख्यमंत्री बनने के बाद पहले दिन से उन्होंने खाद कारखाने से जुड़ी हर मांग स्वीकार कर कार्य को आगे बढ़ाया। केंद्रीय उर्वरक मंत्री ने कहा कि हम पहले 80 से 90 लाख मीट्रिक टन खाद का आयात करना पड़ता था। प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी के आत्मनिर्भरता के विजन से आयात पर निर्भरता समाप्त करने को गोरखपुर समेत 5 स्थानों पर नए प्लांट लगाए जा रहे हैं। इन प्लांटों से 62 लाख मीट्रिक टन खाद का उत्पादन सुनिश्चित होगा। गोरखपुर का खाद कारखाना शुरू होने के बाद उत्तर प्रदेश बिहार के किसानों को समय से और उचित मूल्य पर यूरिया खाद की उपलब्धता सुनिश्चित हो जाएगी। श्री गौड़ा ने कहा कि पीएम मोदी की दूरदर्शिता से कोविड काल के बावजूद खाद की बिक्री में 60% का इजाफा हुआ। केंद्र और प्रदेश सरकार के लिए किसानों का हित सर्वोपरि है। उन्होंने कहा कि किसानों का हित सरकार की शीर्ष प्राथमिकता है और इसी सिलसिले में ऐसी व्यवस्था बनाई जा रही है कि खाद सब्सिडी का 100% पैसा सीधे किसानों के खाते में पहुंचे। केंद्र रसायन व उर्वरक मंत्री श्री गौड़ा ने कहा कि मुख्यमंत्री योगी आदित्यनाथ की पहल पर गोरखपुर में शीघ्र ही प्लास्टिक पार्क की स्थापना होगी। इससे बड़ी संख्या में रोजगार का सृजन होगा। उन्होंने बताया कि प्लास्टिक पार्क के लिए राज्य सरकार ने 52 एकड़ भूमि की व्यवस्था कर दी है। अप्रैल माह के अंत तक इसके लिए DPR तैयार हो जाएगा। इसके अलावा UP के अयोध्या व वाराणसी में 2 CPET केंद्रों का वर्चुअल शुभारंभ प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी द्वारा 1 माह के अंदर किया जाएगा। तकरीबन 6.5 साल बाद गोरखपुर आए केंद्रीय उर्वरक व रसायन मंत्री डीवी सदानंद गौड़ा ने गोरखपुर के विकास को देख सीएम योगी की मुक्त कंठ से तारीफ की। उन्होंने कहा कि बतौर रेल मंत्री जब वह गोरखपुर आए थे तो सांसद के रूप में योगी आदित्यनाथ की संजीदगी और सेवा के कायल हो गए थे। आज गोरखपुर पहुंचने पर यहां हुए असाधारण विकास को देखकर उन्हें यकीन ही नहीं हो रहा था कि यह वही गोरखपुर है जहां वह 6 साल पहले आए थे। पीएम मोदी के विजन पर चलते हुए सीएम के रूप में योगी जी ने 4 साल के अल्प समय में आश्चर्यजनक विकास कार्य किए हैं।
एक बार फिर से माननीय श्री डीवी सदानंद गौड़ा जी का आज के इस PC में और इस निरीक्षण कार्यक्रम के दौरान हृदय से अभिनंदन करता हूं और मैं उन्हें सादर आमंत्रित भी करता हूं कि वह यहां पर इस प्लांट की प्रोग्रेस के बारे में यहां पर मीडिया के माध्यम से आप सबको अवगत कराने का कष्ट करें। माननीय श्री डीवी सदानंद गौड़ा।
चीफ मिनिस्टर हैज एक्सप्लेन द इश्यूज पर्टेनिंग टू दिस वर्क पर प्लांट इन डिटेल, बट इट इज माय रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू थैंक हिम बिकॉज the chief minister himself, how much dedication he has in each and every developmental activities of the state. As he rightly said, I came somewhere in 2014 to Gorakhpur as a railway minister. There was an accident and at that time honorable chief minister was the parliament member. Today when I landed in Gorakhpur, I was surprised to see whether it is a Gorakhpur or not. The developments that has been taken place in Gorakhpur, it is really wonderful, and I need to congratulate the Honorable Chief Minister for doing such an extraordinary developments in Gorakhpur within a very short period. Of course, after independence, nearly 70 years are over, but within a short span of 4 to 5 years, what has been not achieved last 70 years, that has been done by our Honorable Chief Minister, and this sort of development is the vision of the Honorable Prime Minister also. Honorable Chief Minister said that the vision of the Prime Minister for self-reliance is the base for this revival of this plant. But I have seen Honorable Chief Minister, the then Parliament member, on the floor of the House, he was demanding that this plant should be revived. I think certainly your share is also there, sir, for revival of this plant, and certainly your dreams are coming true by the end of July. Today, even in the review meeting, Honorable Chief Minister telling that, sir, the date need to be preponed. He was telling the MD and other officers that we should start operating by June 30th. That should be the date. You should prepone. We should show to the whole country that in Uttar Pradesh, a plant that has been scheduled to be operational by July 31st is operated in June 30th. This is the vision of one chief minister who wants to have developments. Sir, you have throughout, right from day one till today, my MD, my secretary, everybody was telling that whatever demands that we placed before your table, within a minute you used to give us. So I thank for this extraordinary support given by you. The vision of the Honorable Prime Minister, when he assumed the charge of the Prime Minister, that self-reliance in all the areas in our country should be there, accordingly in fertilizer division also. At present we are importing about 80 to 90 lakh metric tons. Total consumption in India is around about 320 to 330 lakh metric tons, out of which about 80 to 90 lakh metric tons we are importing. Prime Minister has a vision that the import should be minimized, indigenous production should be supported. So in 2016, according to his wish, the cabinet gave approval for five fertilizer units for revival: Gorakhpur, Ramagundam, Sindri, Barauni and Talcher. Except Talcher, the other four units will be operational through gas, and Talcher, the new technology under coal based, all units are installed capacity of 12.7 lakh metric tons. That means around about 62 lakh metric tons will be added within a year or so. Ramagundam is ready for operational. We are going to operate this unit by the end of June, July, and by the end of December 2021, we are going to see that the other two units, Sindri and Barauni, also should be operational. Lakh metric tons. The farmers of this area, especially Purvanchal, that is Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, they will get timely urea without any much delay, with affordable cost. Say, HURL team is also doing extremely good work. Now already nearly in total 98% of our work is completed, and there are small hitches are there that will be completed, and we hope that before the scheduled time we are going to operate this. Here also 2.7 lakh metric tons will be manufactured, and thereby the self-reliance will be given more importance. In Gorakhpur, it will give push for the youngsters for their activities. Nearly 1,500 people, not only inside the plant, even outside the plant, they will be get several jobs here and there. And apart from that, the economy will grow. The Gorakhpur economy will grow like anything in the coming days. Sir, already you have given approval that we are going to have a plastic park also here in Gorakhpur, about 52 acres of land, which has been already approved by the state government with immediate consent. So we also asked them to give the detailed project report by the end of April, so that we are going ahead with that also. Plastic park will create a huge number of employment generation here in Gorakhpur. Apart from the two CPET centers, one in Ayodhya and one in
Varanasi.
That also approved. The Honorable Prime Minister is going to inaugurate it virtually within a month. We have already requested. Why we are providing all these of AIIMS has already come to Gorakhpur? Because the state government is cooperating in such an extent, they are so much welcoming the central government schemes. So we are also feeling happy that a project which is given to the state of Uttar Pradesh will be implemented within the stipulated period. Now, I don't want to say much about our department's initiatives. We have started DBT through POSH missions, the fertilizers are being supplied to the farmers, and weekly the subsidy calculations are being done, and 100% subsidy payments are being made to the producers. And now we are planning for the DBT2, wherein the subsidy will be directly, it will be credited to the account of the farmer. So the farmer will be benefited to a considerable extent, and there will not be any confusion as far as subsidy matters are concerned. We are working on it. It is on pipeline. We hope that our department is taking it very seriously, and we will do that also. These are the areas of concern. You may be surprised to know, during COVID period, the one sector which shown positive growth, that is our fertilizer industry. So during COVID, 16% more urea was sold, 40% more NPK fertilizer sold. You know very well, if one unit which produces fertilizers, if one man is infected, automatically the factory has to be shut. If because of the standard operating procedures of various states, the movement was so tough. If the imported urea is to be unloaded in the port, if something goes wrong there, it may not be possible. But day by day, every day, it was increasing, and the Prime Minister was regularly visiting to our website, wherein we have got a web portal which identifies and gives a clear picture what is the production, what is the supply chain, what is the stock there in the state or the district level. All these things will come out at the web portal. He used to channelize everything, and we were able to succeed, and thereby we gave all sorts of support to the farmers, and agriculture sector is the one sector which showed growth during COVID period also. So fertilizer is one of the important areas of this, and I think certainly the Purvanchal farmers will appreciate the initiatives taken by Honorable Prime Minister and Honorable Chief Minister as far as the fertilizer units are concerned. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So you are doing your way.